Good morning, children. After so many days, we are starting our English, and we have already finished Art is for Everyone. And this is the second chapter in your syllabus, which will be coming in your unit test in the month of June, and that is Black Beauty. Now, I would love to revise your Art is for Everyone once more, but not now. First, we will do this lesson, probably. Then we will realize both the lessons together and we'll be holding our revision test also. Now, Black Beauty. This lesson is about a beauty which is black. And what would it be? It would be a black horse. So now let's read the story and understand the underlying meanings and words of lot of difficult words in the chapter, and so on. We will start proceeding the lesson. Black Beauty. Think as far back as you can remember. What are your earliest memories of the place you live or lived in? What do you remember about the house and its surroundings? Who were your playmates? What games did you play? Is there any incident that you remember from that time? Share these memories with your classmates. Now, here the author just tells you that if you have your past memories of a house where you lived in, maybe with your grandparents in your village, or you had been going to your grandparents when you were a small child, if you have some past memories, you share with your friends that how the house was, how the village was, how clean the atmosphere was, how much greenery did you see in your village, and all those things. So let us read about the early memories of a horse named Black Beauty. Now, you have early memories, even a small horse, black horse, also had its memories. Now, it is the horse who's talking in the lesson. He is narrating the story. And who's that horse? He's that black horse. He's a small baby of the horse. His name is Black Beauty. Now, he's saying, the first place I can remember was a large pleasant meadow with a pond of clear water in it. Now, what does he say? That the first thing he remembers when he was a small child, that there was a large meadow. Now, what is a meadow? A meadow is a place which has greenery all over and there are flowers all over and you have mountains on its sides. So that place is a meadow. You can see a meadow, a green meadow. And there was a clear pond of water in it. There was a pond which has clear water. Some shady trees, and then there were some shady trees leaned over it. Lean means jhuke hue the. Lean down, jhukna. Lean down means to bend down. And the trees leaned over it. Rushes and water lilies grew at the deep end. Now, the water was rushing. Now, rushes means tall plants with grass-like leaves. Now, if there are tall plants in the meadow, in the pond, so it was basically, there were tall plants with grass-like leaves in that pond and water lilies. There are some lily flowers which grow in the water. That water lilies grew, past tense of growers grew at the deep end. So the pond, the Black Beauty is explaining the pond in this paragraph. Over the hedge on one side, we looked into a ploughed field, and on the other, we looked over a gate at our master's house, which stood by the roadside. Now, over the hedge, Rama, big hedge, thi, uske ek side mein ploughed. Matlab, ploughed means that a land which has been ploughed for farming. Aap ek jab kheti ke liye land ko tayar karte ho. So that ploughed field was there on one side, and on the other there was a gate at the master's house which stood by the roadside. So he has explained the whole meadow in so many words, this small Black Beauty horse. In the daytime, I ran by my mother's side, and at night I laid down close to her. Din mein I used to just run with my mother, she's a mother, and at the night I used to just lie down close to her. Uske saath so jata tha. When it was hot, we used to stand by the pond in the shade of the tree. Jab garmi hoti thi, I used to stand just near the pond. Because it used to be hot, So I wanted to stand near the pond. So it gave me a lot of freshness and lot of coolness. And it was cold. We had a nice warm shed near the plantation. जब ठंड होती थी तो मैं फिर जो शेड जो एक शेड हमारे लिए बना हुआ था उसकी वहाँ पे वार्म शेड में प्लांटेशन मतलब प्लांट्स के पास हम वहाँ जाकर रेस्ट करते थे. As soon as I was old enough to stay on my own, my mother used to go out to work in the daytime and come back in the evening. As soon as I was old enough to stay on my own, when I was small, my mother never left me. But when I became old, when I grew up, my mother used to just leave me and she used to go out to work in the daytime and come back in the evening. So when you are small babies, your parents cannot leave you. But when you become little older, you can always stay at home with your brothers, sisters, and your parents can go for the job, for the work. Similarly, his mother also started going when he became little older. There were 6 young colts in the meadow besides me. Now, what is a colt? Colt is a baby of a horse. So there were 6 young colts. I had 6 more friends in the meadow besides me. Besides me, मतलब मेरे अलावा 6 लोग और थे, तो कितने total हो गए? 7. So they were older than I was. They were all older than me. Some were nearly as large as grown-up horses. कुछ तो ऐसे थे, बिल्कुल grown-up horses थे. I used to run with them. We had great fun. We used to canter round and round the field as hard as we could. Used to canter means round, round, meadow के around, circle, circle में दौड़ना. Because horses, they run. They canter around. Canter. It's a new word. Canter round and round the field as hard as we could go. Sometimes we had rather rough play for the colts would bite and kick as well as gallop. Now sometimes when we used to play, we used to have a rough play. As you play with your friends, sometimes you hit each other, sometimes you push each other. So similarly, they also used to have a rough play, all these colts. They would bite, they would kick, as well as they would gallop. Gallop is how a horse gallops. I'll show you in the video a galloping and a cantering of a horse. So you will be able to add these words in your dictionary or add these words in your mind that there are a lot of words which shows that what a horse does. So this is what he was talking about in the first page. Then one day when there was a good deal of kicking, my mother winned to me to come to her, and then she said, I wish you pay attention to what I am going to say. One day when I was playing with my friends and I had a good deal of kicking, when I had kicked a lot of friends, my mother called me and she advised me something. She says, listen to me. The colts that live here are very good, but some of them have not learnt manners. Your father has a great name. For 2 years, your grandmother won the New Market Race Cup. Your grandmother had the sweetest temper of any horse I have ever knew, and you have never seen me kick or bite. I hope you will grow up gentle and good and never learn bad ways. Do your work with goodwill. Lift your feet up well when you trot, and never bite or kick even in play. Now her mother gave him a piece of advice. He says, fine, you play with your friends, you kick, you gallop, but kicking is not good. Why? Because it is not good manners. It's similarly when your parents give you a piece of advice, when you fight with your friends or when you push each other, they all say you that don't do that. It doesn't look good. You belong to a good family. You have good parents. So don't spoil our name. Similarly, her mother also said that his father has a great name and his grandmother had won the New Market Race Cup, and we belong to a very, very royal and a good family, and you should not behave like this. You should not spoil the name of the family. I hope you grow up gentle and good and never learn bad ways. So she says, do your good work with goodwill, lift your feet up well when you trot, and never bite or kick even in the play. That's what advice her mother gave it to Black Beauty. Why did Black Beauty's mother call him? Which word is used to describe the sound she made? Please answer. I have never forgotten my mother's advice. Our mother. So he says that I have never forgotten my mother's advice. And our master was very fond of my mother because she was a very wise and good lady. And her name was Duchess. But our master called her Pet. So he is narrating the whole story about his mother and about his master and about himself, that how naughty he was when he was a child and how her mother gave him a piece of advice. Now our master gave us good food, good lodging. Now he is talking about his master, that he gave us good food. Good lodging means good stay. And kind words. He spoke as kindly to us as he did to his little children. He was a good man. We all liked him very much. And my mother was devoted to him. When she saw him at the gate, she would neigh with joy and trot up to him. Whenever my mother used to saw our master, she used to neigh. How does a horse do? He neighs. And he just trot up to him. Trot up, matlab apne dono four legs ko, not hind legs, four legs ko, aage ke dono pairon ko uthana, usko trotting bolte. He would pat and stroke her and say, "Well, old pet, how is your little cold today?" Now he would pat her. Pat means shabashi dena. He would pat her and stroke her and say, "Well, old pet, how is your little cold today? How is your little child today?" Then he would give me a piece of bread, which was very good. He often brought a carrot for my mother. All the horses would come to him, but I think we were his favorites. My mother always took him to town in a light gig. That is, my mother only used to take him to the gig. Gig means a small light carriage pulled by one horse. Then there was a plowboy. Now plowboy, boy who guides the animals drawing a plow. There was a plowboy, Dick, who sometimes came into our field to pluck blackberries from the hedge. Now he says there was a plowboy. Now who is a plowboy? A plowboy is a boy who guides the animal drawing a plow. Plow means farming करने के लिए, plowing करने के लिए there is a plowboy जो horses को, जो animals को guide करता है. Now his name was Dick. He used to come to our fields to pluck blackberries. Blackberries are kind of a fruit from the hedge. When he had eaten all he wanted, he would have what he called fun with the colts. Now what he would do? He would first eat all the blackberries and he would make fun with the colts. Colts means with the small horses, throwing stones and sticks at them to make them gallop. What he used to do? He used to throw stones on the horses so that they gallop, so that they make noise, so that they start running. And the stones often hurt us. Aur woh stones hame matlab dukhte the, matlab hame hurt hota tha. One day he was at the cruel game when the master came to the next field. One day he was doing that cruel game, suddenly the master came. As Dick did not know that he was being watched by the master, he continued throwing stones at us. The master jumped over the hedge in a snap and went up to Dick. "Bad boy," he scolded. "Bad boy, to chase the colts. I shall not want you on my farm again." The master sent Dick away, so we never saw him again. Old Daniel, the man who looked after the horses, was told to look after us. Since he was just as kind and gentle as our master, we were comfortable and happy. So after that, Dick never came to the fields, to the field, because he was throwing stones and he was playing bad games with us and making the horse hurt. So after that, we were all looked after by old Daniel, who used to look after the horses, and he took good care of us. So this is a small story which has been narrated by a colt named Black Beauty about his master, about the meadow, about his mother, about his behavior, and about his plays and games which he had played with his friends in the meadow with other horses. So I believe you have understood the story, and I would like you to just see few words which I'll be giving you in the video, and with the name, please. So with this we end up the story, and just read the story at least three times. And I'll be giving you some small some words with their meanings in the picture. Just remember them and spell them and do some difficult words in dictation, which I'll be just writing down after the video. Thanks.